Hi, Cancer. Welcome to your December 8, 2018. What they aren't telling you reading. So like I said, this is for December 2018. Everything you need to know about this reading is in the description box below. Two more. Lord. All right, one more. Ten of Rods. So this could be somebody that is just, it's just too much, this work. It's too much to bear anymore. They might be thinking about they need a break or an ending, that it's just a lot of stress and hard work. Temperance, Knight of Wands, the Tower, King of Wands or Rods in this deck, Four of Rods, the High Priest, could be Taurus, and Three of Swords. I will clarify with this where it makes sense to do so. So it could be Sagittarius, Scorpio, Taurus. All right, so things appear, your partner, Cancer, is presenting themselves to be balanced, taking time to heal, pulling back. This could be somebody, a breakup imminent or a breakup that's happened. And the reality is, so it might look like they're just kind of taking some time to heal and think things through and sort of waiting with purpose, having patience, thinking things over. But it could be that they are actually wanting that forward movement. So it looks like they're being patient and they pulled back and they're all for moderation and what's best. And but they're actually wanting some forward movement, maybe wanting some action. This is like the energy building, momentum building up to actually moving forward. So they, in essence, they could be chomping at the bit here, Cancer. All right, couple scenarios, because for some of you, I feel like this might be a breakup that has happened. Like you and your partner, because this is pulling back and not having really any, this is just pulling back, recentering, rebalancing. So maybe this, okay, so this could be a couple that has had some time apart. And while it looks like they're taking that time, they actually want to come back in and get things going again. On a grand scale, they want to, they really want to get things going again. Because they want forward movement. This is all about moving forward. This is all about progressing in that relationship with you. So if there's been a breakup, they want back in and they want to move forward. If you are still in the relationship, it might look like they're being very kind of patient and kind, but they really do want forward movement. So it looks like they're being patient, kind, and in moderation. They're just kind of, hey, whatever's going to happen is going to happen. But in reality, they really want things to be happening. They're probably saying, we could go and do this. We could go, let's do this here. Let's go there, this, that. I want to live life to the fullest. I really want to be involved with you. And they mean it. What they're not telling you is that they've got future plans for possibly marriage or at least a connected, committed relationship with you. This, what they say they're going to do, they say, I'm going to marry you. Okay, it could be that. I want a commitment with you. I want to know you biblically, if they don't already. And yet, they really want to break your heart? What? No. Come on now. What's going on here? All right, why are they saying all this forward movement business? What's going on there? Let's clarify that, please. Forward movement. What's this King of Wands about? Look at that. Yep. They're wanting to do all kinds of stuff with you and to you. This is forward movement. This is passion. Can do Cameron. Somebody wants to be out there in the mix, living life to the fullest. Natural born leader, has a vision for the future. Passionate, self-confident. Could be fire sign Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. If it's not, it's somebody that has those qualities. And this is suited, which means that they see you two as, you two as equals, suited, match, their mate, that sort of thing. Could be man or woman here. Because why? Because they want to get married, or they have this relationship they want to have with you. They want a happy home, a communal home with you. This is going on a journey. You know, that's what this king does. He gets out there and has adventures. Same with her. She facilitates them. She makes the plans, he drives. That sort of thing. Those all fell. All right. What's this Four of Wands about? So while they're saying, yeah, let's go do this, let's do that, it's because... Okay. Okay, so if this has been a breakup, it's somebody that sees you still as being a part of them and they want back in. They want to progress forward. Why? Because they hate feeling disconnected from you. There's some kind of disconnect. Either they're just broken, literally broken without you, and they're bereft without you. Not so much financially, but emotionally, they feel disconnected without you. If you are with them, they don't want to lose you. This is them feeling like without this commitment from you, it's almost like they feel at a loss if they don't get a commitment from you. They really see you two as suited and mated. All right, so they're talking about they want to marry you. They want you to marry them. But what they really want to do, why do we have the Three of Swords here? Talk about a disconnect. What the hell? And we got the Hierophant again. We got the Hierophant over here. We got the Hierophant over here. I just don't see it. I don't understand that. Maybe the Oracle cards will help. That does not make sense to me. So they're saying they want to get married. They want this commitment. Commitment. Suited. And being patient and loving, but I want forward movement. I want marriage. I want this relationship to progress. But they're brokenhearted. They want to break your heart. What in the heck? And then we've got this right here. This could be achievement. You know, like, hey, we've reached that point to where, you know, we're just going to keep doing the same thing, but I really would like to take it to the next level with you. Because after this is that new beginning, or the, you know, pages are similar to aces in that sense. So after the 10 comes the page, but here we've got this horrible, you know, somebody just, the weight of anxiety and burden is just crushing them. The anxiety is like too much to bear here. So is this somebody with an internal struggle? You know, these two things right here, this is a little worrisome. All right, what's this Tower about? Again with the Temperance and Two of Wands reversed. Expect the unexpected, receive it with balance and compassion, and expect delays. There's going to be frustration and delays. So this whole thing is about someone wanting forward movement, but not being able to, and feeling lost and sad without this forward movement. So this, to me, this feels like there's been a breakup and somebody wants back in, and they don't. All right, give me more on this Three of Swords here. What the heck is going on there? There's gonna be delays. You know, this could be somebody that's, okay. Wow, that took a turn. All right, because what I was going to say was this could be somebody that's caught in a third-party situation and they're going to break it off with that other person so they can be with you. That maybe the stress of carrying both is too hard for them. Like they're sitting back waiting, but they really want to move forward. They want to get back in there. They want you to choose them. They see you as suited and mated. They want to get married. They want to make that commitment. They some kind of commitment, cementing the deal. And yet this is about them loss, sadness, sorrow, grief, rejection, painful separation here. And when, you know, so we've got this painful separation of a marriage and somebody not being in a secure position and unhealthy attachment issues, can't get out of their own head, wanting to shake things up. This could be Capricorn. Interesting. Okay. Cancer, this is like all over the place here. I'm kind of thinking it's somebody that broke up with somebody and they want back in. They're wanting to, they're talking this big game because they, but they don't, there's like this conflict. They want this joint relationship, but there's this incredible disconnect and sadness there. And then they're saying that they want this connection in this marriage, but it's, is somebody just, you know, wanting to break somebody's heart with this? This is a Taurus right here. The King of Pentacles reverse could be Capricorn. This is Capricorn. Taurus, this is Taurus. Or Virgo. And this is somebody that's very controlling and domineering. Or it could be a male that's not at all secure. I think that's what it is. Or a female that's not at all secure. This is somebody that wants to be with you, Cancer, because you provide the security that they do not have unless they are with you. And they want that marriage and that connection. We got three marriage cards here. They want that connection and marriage. It seems like they're pulling back, taking the time, thinking about things. Everything's fine. I'm compassionate. I'm waiting. I'm patient. I'm balanced. But in reality, they really want this forward movement because without you, they feel brokenhearted and they're not telling you that. They're giving you the impression that, oh yeah, you know, or the, if you're even talking, because there's something about a distance and separation here and why they want to. This is about returning and coming back right here. So either you're separated with them or they're holding things back and making it seem one way, but really what they're not telling you is that they really want to be connected. They see you as suited or mated. And without you, there's this loss and profound sadness without you. They don't feel secure and they feel untethered and unhealthy and there's you, you provide a level of security and safety for them that they, without you, they feel that. They feel that loss and that disconnect, okay? So they're wanting the marriage, if nothing, you know, screw the fact that they love you, right? There's like major anxiety. It's almost like something is too much to bear unless they are tethered to you. It's very kind of strange. And this right here is about, there needs to be some kind of shakeup. It's almost like this is an unhealthy connection, okay? Because the reasons for wanting to get married are not what they should be. There's nothing about cups or love here. And the overall theme is very stressful and burdened and too much to bear, to the point where it's just stressing somebody the hell out. So somebody in this relationship is stressing the other person out. And while they might be acting like everything's fine and I want to get married and there's forward movement and yes, we're together, what's really going on is that they need you and that they don't feel tethered or secure without you. And it's an unhealthy need for you. It's almost like they can't make it on their own without you. And your advice is to, I hate to say it, but it might be to break up. This is a 10 of rods, and this is saying that it's just too much to bear. Tens are completion numbers anyway, the end of a cycle. And this is the Tower, like suggesting a break. Expect the unexpected. Take a break. Break it off. Take a break. Heal. Think about things. Balance. Recenter. Ground. Consider what you want. Have, you know, take a look at this realistically and, you know, don't do anything. Don't make any plans. I'm sorry, but it's like break it off. You need to go to ground. You need to heal. You need to go by yourself somewhere, or you need to have time to think, because this one's coming at you like a freight train and they want that marriage and that connection. Why? Because they feel insecure without you. This is somebody that it cannot life. They cannot adult without you. This is somebody that is not healthy or stable on their own. took a turn, didn't it? All right, for Cancer. Sacred Earth Mother, a message of love. You know, the word mother jumps out at me. I'm just saying this is somebody that really finds that safety and security and that nurturing with you. And that's great. You know, that's a component of love, but it can't be the only thing that your partner gets from you. You know what I mean, Cancer? It's like, that can't be the only thing that they're attracted to you about, that, oh, you make me feel good and safe and secure, and I know that you love me. Okay, but I have needs too, you know? All right, Cancer. Yep. Bearing the weight for others, bearing the weight of others. This is probably speaking to you being in that supportive position, but someone might be taking advantage of that or gotten too comfy with it. So while they're sitting pretty, you're like, my back's breaking here. My back's breaking. Okay. So, and this is a 9 and this is a 10, just saying. So, this is, and they might very well come back in and be like, I love you. And they might think they love you, and that's very sweet. And that's a component of love, but you want the other stuff too, you know? This is all great until I clarified it, damn it. But we've got this profound sense of feeling lost or disconnected, which is very sweet, but you don't want to be somebody's parent in a romantic relationship. You know, there's got to be more to it than just them wanting to get back in because they feel safe and secure. Cancer. Yeah, quiet time. Take some quiet time alone to rest, meditate, and contemplate. That's exactly what this is saying right here. You need to get to a safe place. Break it off, take a break, do a break, no contact, whatever you got to do for this quiet time and this rest right here. Okay? That's your advice. No contact, no planning, no anything. You need time to think. And it's funny because this is all about Temperance also, like that same kind of message. And that's how they appear. That's what they're giving you, that impression, like everything's fine, but it's really not. What they're not telling you is they need to get in there because you're their safe place, not their happy place. You're their safe place. There's a difference. They see you as suited and matched. This could also be that they're telling, like, I'm going to do this, and we're going to do this, and we're going to have this. And really, they're actually wanting to just sort of be a part of that and not really make it happen. So they might be talking a big game, but they really just want to be a part of it. Okay, sometimes this queen, she facilitates, but this is the one that goes out there and slays the dragon. She cooks them. You know what I mean? So while they might be talking a big game, they might just be saying what you want to hear because they just want to be a part of what you could provide. Okay. All right. Okay, Cancer, food for thought, lots to think about, right? I hope this was helpful, and I do hope that you get some clarity on this. I hope this helped. This is epiphanies and breakthroughs also. So hopefully with some quiet time, you know, you might get that message of love. That's nice. But with some quiet time, you'll kind of see the dynamics of it, the nuances of it, because this is great. You know, somebody loves you and they want to get married, but what's in it for you, you know? Okay. All right, Cancer. I hope this was helpful, and I hope to see you in the next reading. You take care.